Hello student, in this video we are going to discuss about the basic of physical quantity and measurement. In this video we are going to discussing about measurement and its importance, measurement of length, measurement of mass, measurement of time and measurement of area. In this figure we can see that two persons are comparing their height, but here we can see that a tailor measuring the trouser of a person. So here he use a measuring tape for measurement purpose. Have you ever prepared Maggie in your home? It's how many time required? It take maximum 5 minutes. But when your mother prepare rice, it take up to 20 minutes to 30 minutes. So what is the difference? We require less time for preparing Maggie and we require more time to preparing rice. I know that most of you see the cartoon serial Motu and Patlu. Is the mass of Motu is same as mass of Patlu? No, Motu is heavier than Patlu. Here we only compare the mass of Motu and Patlu. Have you touched the hot water in your bare hand? Don't do like this, it may cause injury. But we can touch ice by hand easily because ice is cold. Here only we compare the hotness and coldness of ice and water. In fourth picture we see the comparison between height, time, mass and temperature. So what is measurement? Measurement is a basically process of comparison. So we can define measurement as the process of comparison of the given unknown quantity with a fixed known quantity of the same kind is called measurement. Every measurement process must have a unit. For example, we can measure length by meter, centimeter, kilometer, etc. We can measure mass by gram, kilogram, quintal, etc. We can measure temperature by the help of centigrade, Fahrenheit, Kelvin and Römer. We can measure time by the help of hour, minute, second, day, week, month, year, etc. The length is someone measure by meter, someone by centimeter and someone by kilometer. But internationally a unit is accepted, that is called SI unit. So we can define SI unit as the measurement of unit which is accepted internationally is called standard international unit and written as SI unit. When we written a unit, some point we have to remember. The symbol of unit always written in small letter, that is kg in small, meter in small, second in small, but Fahrenheit, ampere, Newton and Kelvin are written in capital letter because the Fahrenheit, ampere, Newton and Kelvin are name of scientist. But when we written the unit in word, it is always written in small letter. When we write the unit and its symbol, we never written in plural form because it is wrong procedure. If we write meters, seconds and kgs, these are wrong. We have to write meter, second and kg. When we write two units in product form, at that time we have to left a space between them. Negative power are used for the compound unit formed by dividing one unit by other unit. For example, kilometer by hour, that can we write kilometer per hour, or we can written as kilometer into h to the power minus 1. First we discuss about measurement of length. Length is the distance between two points. We can measure distance by measuring rule, measuring tape, scale, etc. The SI unit of length is meter and denoted as M. In this figure we can see a 10 cm scale. So the distance between 0 to 1 is 1 cm and there is small spacing of 10 line. This is 1 mm. So we can write 10 mm equal to 1 cm. So now tell me, what is the distance between 0 to 7? It is 7 सेंटीमीटर और 70 मिलीमीटर। इन द अबव स्केल वी कैन सी दैट देयर आर टू मेजरिंग यूनिट प्रेजेंट, वन इज इंच एंड अनदर इज सेंटीमीटर। सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट सेंटीमीटर मिलीमीटर, बट हियर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इंच। सो 1 इंच इक्वल टू 2.54 सेंटीमीटर एंड 1 फुट इक्वल टू 12 इंच। लेट्स टेक एन एग्जांपल ऑफ मेजरमेंट। सो व्हाट इज द डिस्टेंस ऑफ दिस व्हाइट लाइन? इट इज 1 2 3 4 5, इट इज 5 सेंटीमीटर लेंथ। लेट्स टेक अनदर एग्जांपल। व्हाट इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू पॉइंट ऑफ दिस रोप? इट इज 20 सेंटीमीटर। और व्हेन वी मेजर इन इंच, इट इज 8 इंच। इन दिस पिक्चर नाउ वी कैन क्लियरली सी दैट हाउ द डॉक्टर टेक द हाइट ऑफ दिस चाइल्ड बाय द हेल्प ऑफ मेजरिंग स्केल। हियर आई विल प्रोवाइड यू सम टेबल ऑफ यूनिट कन्वर्शन ऑफ लेंथ। सो यू पॉज द वीडियो, टेक योर कॉपी एंड राइट डाउन द यूनिट कन्वर्शन। Here we can see a measuring tape. This is generally used by carpenter and engineer. So what is this? This measuring tape provide two measurement unit, that is one is centimeter and another is inch. So when we require in inch, we can easily measure through inch, and when we require in centimeter, we can easily measure through centimeter scale. Next we discuss about measurement of mass. Mass is the quantity of matter contained in a body. The SI unit of mass is kilogram and denoted as kg. In this picture you can see that lion is heavier than monkey. But can you say that what is the weight of monkey here? No. Well, we don't know this weight of this monkey. To know the mass of the monkey, we have to use proper device, that is beam balance or electronics balance. In electronics balance method, the device is check the mass of this body and display on the 7 segment display, that is the blue color display on this picture. Next is our beam balance method. In beam balance method, we have to keep one known quantity of mass one side and another quantity of object in another side. At that time what happen? The beam balance check the weight of both side, which side is more mass, that is go downward, and which is less mass, that is upward. In this picture we see a image of beam balance. Beam balance consists of three main part. One is beam, another is pointer, and the last one is scale pen. The weight of scale pen are always equal. When both side equal, at that time the pointer is at center point. When the weight of one side increase, at that time the pointer move that side. In this way we measure the weight of the object that is our unknown to us. In market, shop, we always see the beam balance method, which is used for measuring purpose. In this figure you can see some example of weight cell, that is of 10 kg, 5 kg, 2 kg, 1 kg, 500 gram, 200 gram, 100 gram and 50 gram. In general purpose, this weight cell are used for measuring purpose in shop, market and where you purchase different things. Here I will show you unit conversion table of mass. Write down in your copy. So what are the unit of mass? That is milligram, gram and kg. We generally found medicine in milligram. We purchase sugar in gram or kilogram, and we purchase rice, dal in kilogram. The next one is measurement of time. What is time? The interval between two instant or any event is called time. We measure time in terms of mean solar day. The SI unit of time is second, and it is denoted as small s. So what is solar day? Solar day can be defined as the time taken by the earth to complete one complete rotation around its own axis, that is 1 day. So 1 day equal to 24 hour, 1 hour equal to 3600 second, so 1 second equal to 1/84000 part of a solar day. So 1 second equal to 1/86400 part of a mean solar day. Here I have written some basic unit of time, that is second, minute and hour. You have to write down in your copy 1 day, 1 week, 1 month and different day in month and 1 year, that is normal year as well as leap year. In another way, we can define as 1 second is the time interval between two consecutive ticks that we hear from a pendulum clock. Generally, there are two types of clock available in market, that is analog clock and digital clock. In digital clock, the time is displayed directly, but in analog clock, it displays the time through its hand. There are three arms present in a analog clock. Those are hour hand, minute hand and second hand. The second hand is rotated one time in 1 minute, but the minute arm rotates one complete rotation for 1 hour and the hour arm rotates complete two rotation for 1 day. In pendulum clock, two arms are present. Those are hour arm and minute arm. Here, the pendulum is act as second arm of this clock. The next one is stopwatch. The stopwatch is generally used in the field of sports. When a athlete run of 100 meter run, 200 meter run, 400 meter run or any other run, at the time to know about the correct time, in how many times he covers the distance, the stopwatch is used. The last one is measurement of temperature. Temperature is the degree of hotness or coolness of an object. The SI unit of temperature is Kelvin and denoted as K. Like our mass, length, time, temperature also have unit. That is Celsius, Kelvin, Romer and Fahrenheit. Here only we know about Kelvin, Celsius and Fahrenheit. We measure length by the help of scale, time by stopwatch or clock and mass by weight scale or beam balance. Like this, we can measure temperature by the help of thermometer. There are different type of thermometer, that is clinical thermometer and laboratory thermometer. In clinical thermometer, we can measure from 35 degree centigrade to 42 degree centigrade and 94 degree Fahrenheit to 108 degree Fahrenheit. So, in comment box, tell me what is the body temperature of a human being in both Celsius as well as Fahrenheit. Now, we are going to discuss about the construction of thermometer. The thermometer is mainly made up of mercury, the capillary tube and stem. Here, the Celsius scale and Fahrenheit scale show the deflection of temperature by the help of mercury. So, what is the function of mercury? Mercury is a metal, it is in liquid state. When the mercury absorbs heat from our body, it expands and it increases its volume by the help of capillary tube. And it indicates the body temperature in the Celsius scale as well as Fahrenheit scale. The next one is contraction point. The contraction point not allowed to flow the mercury in reverse direction after measuring of temperature. Next is stem. The glass body of thermometer is called stem. In this figure, we can see three different types of thermometer. First one is clinical thermometer analog type. Next is clinical thermometer digital type. The last one is contactless temperature reader, which is already discovered, but it is recently used for the test of corona and body temperature. Here we read some new thing, that is measurement of area. So what is area? The total surface occupied by an object is called surface area. So we can measurement area by two method. One is formula and another is graphical method. So where can we use formula and where can we use graph? If any object have a definite length and width, at that time we can use formula, and if there is no definite shape, at that time we have to use graphical method. Here first we discuss about formula, and after that we are going to discuss about graphical method. In this figure we can see two geometrical shape, one is square and another is rectangle. So what is the area of square? It is side into side. And what is the area of this rectangle? It is length into breadth. So what is area? Area is the multiplication of two sides. The next geometrical figure are triangle and circle. So area of the triangle is half into base into height. What is height? Height is the perpendicular distance from base to the top of the triangle. The next is circle. Area of circle is pi r square. So what is pi and what is r? Pi, the value of pi is 3.14 or 22/7. So what is r? R is the distance from the center to the outline of this circle. It is we called radius and denoted as r. The another method is graphical method. In graphical method also we can determine the area of an object. That is, first we have to take a graph paper. On the graph paper we have to draw the diagram. After that we have to count number of full square and number of half square. So the formula is number of full square plus half into number of half square, that is 6, plus half into 4 equal to 8 square unit. Here we check the area by the help of formula. So here base is 4 unit and height is also 4 unit. So by the help of formula we can determine that half into base into height, that is half into 4 into 4, answer is here also 8 square unit. So in both the method we can get correct answer.